Hello and welcome back to my walkthrough to Final Fantasy XV. In the last episode, we returned back to Golden Key and also completed some of Cindy's missions and then rescued some people who are in need over here in Golden.
I'm good to go. Just about awake.
The reason that I feel like travelling back to Golden now is really useful is because Dino, obviously, if you hadn't guessed by now, that Dino, along with Dave, is another one of these NPCs who's going to give us essentially a series of quests. So, and you can only undertake each, you know, the next quest once you complete the previous one. So, I felt like it was a good idea just to get this one out of the way. Otherwise, you know, because Golden, like I've said before, is sort of one of the most isolated locations. It's good to sort of do it now because, you know, it's about as far away from everything as, yeah, this is an area where we're really close in many ways to Golden for a significant amount of time. Anyway, so we're now here. We're going to continue to make our travels up towards... So the Gormans of Vanath, we did actually complete that one, so that's just saying that we need to actually cash it in, but...
Everything in order.
The nice thing about hunts is that you can cash them in at any restaurant. So you really don't need to worry about that so much. We really don't need to worry about you know that because we can do that. We could do that in the Prairie Outpost. Sorry, not
is
Prairie.
Really, all that good?
I might have answered before, but yes, it is.
You know, we can. We could stop at Hammerhead. We could stop at Longwythe. All of these places are perfectly fine places for us to actually cash in that. To cash in that mission. Okay, so let's just see if there's anything actually around the Longwythe area we actually would like to continue on with. I don't think the hunts are particularly kind to us around this area, so... but I might be wrong. So we might just...
What do you say we pull over for a minute?
Yeah, my throat's bone dry.
Sounds like grounds for a pit stop.
Sounds like a waste of time.
Time and money.
Ah,
it's always a bit of a spoil sport, is there? Good old Ignis. Anyway, so map. If we just check the map, so you can see that we're actually very close to the area we need to be for this. So we'll just run in here, cash in our next one, and see where it takes us. I mean, we could also actually check the radios because what we haven't done is check the radios since. Obviously, since Lucis fell. Sorry, Insomnia fell. So that would be interesting to see. So,
can I take your order?
I'm pretty sure we already have a.
These are some pretty tough cuts.
So, squash the squirmers located on Longwythe Peak at night time, or. The shield shears at Longwythe Peak all times, so I think that's the next one that makes sense for us. Level 18 is not particularly difficult for us right now.
Good luck.
And it's
you.
Just obviously more more crabs for us to take on.
Take care out there.
So let's check out our these radios.
You dream of driving
me. So that's an advert.
Down the road at dusk should seek refuge at a haven. No doubt that's your best bet right there. Although the Oracle may have left us, may she rest in peace. The Havens are holding strong. Just like they did all during those 4 years after Lady Scylla passed away, and before Lady Luna Freya took up the reins. Just in case, we've got hunters patrolling the Havens and making sure they're safe. So don't you worry.
Man, that smells good.
So I am still young. My blood is true. As my mother before me. I'll work to bring peace to one and all.
That marks the ascension of the youngest oracle in history. Is it hard giving blessings?
It would be selfish of me to complain of my burden when so many suffer and wait. I hope they trust. I will not rest until they all know solace.
The world watched on with worry and wonder. Thunder as the young girl grew. I understand you have a message for us.
If you know of any who are bedridden or unable to come to me, pray, send word, and I shall go to them. I follow my calling. I will not halt my step for anything else.
In time, her strength would become an inspiration to all.
What is your opinion of the treaty?
When war has ended, so too will suffering subside. The treaty is a momentous step towards a brighter future. Let there be no doubt. We walk the path of true peace.
Saw a Magitek trooper the other day.
So, some rather interesting sort of a lot of more information about Luna and how just her character as well, and how she's sort of seen and idolized within this world.
Growing seismic activity has shaken Deskay of late. A number of tremors, which locals refer to as Titan snoring, have been recorded in the region. While the area has always been earthquake prone, the recent spike in frequency and intensity has given rise to concerns. The Imperial Army is currently surveying the disk of Kothis, believed to be the epicenter. Be advised, the area will remain closed off until further notice.
I could eat a horse.
You've issued an advisory to all travelers.
Bad we did. We're asking everyone to keep indoors come nightfall. If you do need to be up past dark, you'll want to make sure there's a hunter by your side. And that includes night driving. Rolling up your windows ain't gonna keep you safe for 1 second.
We'd like to instruct our listeners in need of protection to dial Hunter Headquarters directly.
So there you go, again, more sort of information about Dave, what the Hunters do within this world.
No one has yet been able to grasp the extent of the damage, but what can you tell us about the situation in the city?
Occasional outbursts still occur around the Citadel, but the Imperial forces have successfully quelled most sources of unrest.
Nevertheless, the streets bear the scars of war.
Reports have now surfaced that Lucis was itself arming for an offensive ahead of their clash. This battle may be remembered as one of the most violent in history.
Saw Magitek.
We are Exiner.
You dream of drugs.
It's your vacation.
So I think that is everything, because those are... Oh, maybe one more.
Tenebrae can be seen displayed in memoriam. With no remains to mourn, throngs have gathered in all...
Actually, no, we actually already had heard that one, because that was the one that was in the storyline quest.
Welcome.
Thinking about it, I figured our current food is not actually particularly strong. We've already had Jetty's and Kenny's fries, so we might as well try Kenny's salmon.
Can do.
We'll see if Ignis learns something from this. You never know.
Stomach.
And there we go, another new recipe for us, Kenny's original recipe. So doing quite a nice job there of picking up all of the recipes. I think
Thanks
that's everything here in Longwife that we really need to worry about. And that, I think, further extends to everything in other...
Maldacia, we are...
It's your vacant.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Maldacia. We're now done for radios. But yeah, no, that does really nicely sort of tie in with everything else. In that... Yeah, it means that we no longer need to return to Longwife, we no longer need to consider the food there. So anyway, quest location, it looks like what's really good is that these two quests are really close to one another. So we don't need to worry about, like, you know, traveling too far. So we'll quickly pop over here in the car. The reason we're taking the car is obviously we want to continue to move from here when we actually head over towards... up to Dave to hand in his quest. We gain some AP from our travels. So it looks like Noctis can't actually not sort of trusted to drive until later on. There is obviously a point in the game where Noctis, you can, you know, manually drive everywhere. So, anyway, we'll head over here. We need to find an amethyst stone from here. So pretty much, you're looking for rocks like this, large red ones, and that would generally be the ones that are most valuable to us. Now that we've done that, we can actually continue to head this way to find our hunt. doesn't look like it's... Looks like it might be a bit of a battle, but we'll see.
Thanks.
So, shield shears, let's see. Are you like all other crabs and weak to ice and nothing else? Yes. Weak to ice, strong against fire. Seems to be the crab way. So we'll go to our gear. We'll equip the Blizzaga spell. Blizzara spell that we have.
Ready for this?
Ouch. So, let's see if our friends can't come along and actually help us out here.
Back with us?
There we go. Lovely.
Here I am!
Damn. Yeah, for some reason, we do seem to have quite slow reaction to... it may well just be because we're using... a broadsword. So you're now dead. Good. So we'll see if I use the Sword of the Wise for a bit. Can we actually Well, maybe these guys are just a little too high level for us. They shouldn't be too high level because we're level 18.
That's it.
What's what?
I've come up with a new recipe.
I could taste test for you.
So, Ignis gets a new recipe due to the shield claw, whatever they're called.
No slacking.
And as you can see, so this is, you know, like I was saying, pretty much as soon as you get past this stage in the game, going to start getting more and more involvement from Imperial troops. Nothing that some severe magic can't help with, although as you can see everyone doesn't appreciate the friendly magic the friendly fire a lot. I shouldn't laugh, but like Noctis does what he wants and his friends are just like, no, don't! And then you just chuck this ball of ridiculously strong magic in there. We just need to return to the car. I do like how the car is constantly marked on the map. I think that's it's obviously very, very helpful for us all.
Onward.
So we only have one more cast of Blizzara Thundara, but that's no problem for us. You'll notice that whenever we do, our allies get struck by those sort of spells. They enter, you know, there are status ailments essentially associated with that. I don't quite remember the names of them, but
Imperials,
we'll see.
Above us.
Thanks.
Well, we've already dealt with some Imperials, so we don't need to do that again. We can just go here, go to a... We want to go to a quest location, being... we'll go to Dust to Dust.
Everything in order.
Yep.
And again, letting Ignis take you on these drives is no bad thing, because again, we can gain AP from taking long car journeys. Okay, so let's have a look here. We should actually have some music on. So we start off with the Kingsglaive. The Kingsglaive soundtrack is actually quite nice to listen to. And also, another thing is, eventually we'll actually get access to a to an MP3 player, which allows us to play music whenever we walk, which is pretty cool. Okay, so let's have a look. Yeah, so whenever you've got a little flame, if I cast like fire magic next to our friends, they'll get a small flame next to that, which means that's a burnt status ailment. The ice symbol would be frozen, and the lightning symbol is shocked. So those are the those three statuses. There are a load of others, like an almost exhaustive list of various status effects. For example, the ones that we currently have are obviously attack boost and defense boost. But you know, they could also you get a huge amount of various status effects that we can talk about. So we find the Norderskyan blockade parking spot. This is actually where we'll return to, I think, when we actually get to getting back onto the storyline trail. But very quickly, we will pop back to Dave and finish off his quest. Because again, the reason that I want to finish this quest off is obviously, if we don't finish this quest off, then we can't take it on next time.
Nice. You're being helpful for a change. What do you mean for a change?
And yeah, it's just very important. Well, I feel like it's incredibly useful for us if we actually manage to keep these going. Is that just Oryx Culinary Chronicle? Yeah, that is just Oryx Culinary Chronicle. There. Bit of a mouthful. So, Dave, give us some information.
Thanks for doing your part. Now I'll do my part and return this to that hunter's family.
So, we get Dust to Dust. Not a particularly valuable quest, but a good one nonetheless to do. And we get a bunch of Mega Potions, which is no bad thing. So now we can return to Declaration of War, which requires to head to the Norderskyan Blockade, or, you know, north of Duskai Blockade. Auto to the quest location, to there. We won't fast travel because there's no real point in fast traveling.
Yep.
And we might get some more AP if we travel, besides, with the way, with the way that I'm going to be thinking about sort of like using the cars and stuff, we might as well get used to this, what would you call it? This color scheme on our car.
Ignis, pull over a sec.
Certainly.
So, there we go. We'll arrive here. And now, we will head over towards the various energy deposits that are around here, because I'm pretty sure what we're about to do is we're about to hit up a local haven. Maybe not that one, but maybe one nearby. Lady and Pepper. So yeah, so you got some Anak there, and we don't actually need to worry about these guys at all. As you can see, they're far more scared of us than we are of them. What we do want to do is we want to end up there, so maybe I've made a mistake and we're going to climb up. Here we go. So we're going to pass up through here and meet up with Monica.
From here, we will split into two groups. Prince Noctis, please join the Marshal up ahead. The rest of you will assist me in the diversionary effort.
Okay, so obviously you get the choice to proceed in turn. This isn't an AP choice. This is just, do you want to go into essentially a small section here where we'll go down essentially on rails for a bit.
Do the same on our end.
So yeah, so it's nothing, yeah, you don't get AP, it's just like, do you want to continue with the story? Or do you want to turn back? So there's Core.
Once we're in, we launch our ambush, pushing out while support pushes in, crushing the enemy from both sides.
And now we'll start making our way through this area here. So it can be rather tight and sort of twisty, but ultimately this whole section, the enemies aren't particularly strong, so we really don't need to worry too much. As you can see, they're, level 3? We are by far, you know, way too powerful for that, so you can probably kill everyone with warp strikes if you want to get a nice amount of AP. Just as a thought, you know, thinking about if you want to try and earn yourself some AP. Lovely though, really nice and simple.
Walk through the park.
So it should be. Otherwise, you'd only get in everyone's way.
Could have gotten it alone if I wanted.
That mentality can prove your undoing, Ines.
Above us!
Got it!
So we start seeing these snipers up on the upper levels, but obviously we are Noctis, Lucis, Kylan, and we have the ability to warp strike, so this really is no trouble for us. So we want to warp strike up here. Sorry, point warp to you know, regain our MP up. I was going to use Lion's Roar on that, but nope, Core was just like, I don't even need you to order me about, I can just do this myself. So, that's most of this done.
Be all right on their own.
Worry will only compromise your focus.
Yeah, yeah.
So, we make our way through another door. So yeah, you might have noticed just before those Axemen died to that spell that both Noctis and Core were given the frozen status ailment. But again, no, yeah, nothing to worry about, especially because all of these status ailments will like disappear once you know, you go through once you complete the battle. So anyway, we actually need to head this way. And then another item, a muscle stimulant. So muscle stimulants and items like, such as it are similar to potions in that they're sort of consumables within battle, but they obviously have like stats boosting effects. So strength, vitality, spirit, all that sort of stuff.
Not!
Marshal, it's good to see you again.
All right on your end?
Right as rain. The Nifs couldn't take their eyes off us.
Thanks to you, we were spared their attention.
Stay right where you are! Well, well, if it isn't Core the Immortal. So, you survived the Citadel. But you won't survive what I have in store for you. It's past time your legend came to an end.
So, to finish off Chapter 2, we have a nice big boss battle with Loki. So, we're going to start off by taking out a bunch of these guys through... on. I need somewhere to walk to, if possible. Come on, where's Ignis? Is Ignis healed? Yes, he is. Okay, cool. Ouch. Come on, I just wanna... Is there really no place I can actually, warp? There we go, point warp, finally. There we go, okay, Imperial Sniper. Let's just take these guys out, because they're doing a number on us. Okay, so we can't actually... You can't actually target the cuirass to learn what it's weak to. But we can... do some very nice, so what I might do is I'm just going to go gear, what sort of magic do we want to think about? Maybe some Thundaras in there. We do obviously have Kor able to use his ability, and then Gladio can use his. We'll see if this is super effective. So that looked rather unuseful to me, if I'm honest. So we'll just pop over to Ignis, give him a nice rescue. We need to find Prompto as well. And another nice wet rescue. So we're low on a magic, and also, sorry, on MP. So I'm actually in danger now, so hopefully we'll just quickly heal ourselves up.
Hold your ground.
So, sort of the wise.
Yes, sir.
So he has a status element on him, you'll see, the that sort of, that fist, that lowered fist, that is, that status element is called compromised, and essentially means they have lowered vitality. Ah, there we go, we defeat him. Nice and simple. Goes for a nice big explosion. And there we go. Kor is very much helpful in that battle. It's a bit sort of chaotic.
Impressive. Seeing you in action puts my mind at ease. It's clear I don't need to worry anymore. I'll return to watching the Nifs. Till next time, take care.
So there we go, we complete Chapter 2. And now we'll be able to move on to Chapter 3.
So bad out here once you get used to it.
Still a lot we haven't seen, though.
And a lot for us to do.
Yeah.
Buck up. We're just getting started.
So, there we go. End of chapter. We get, a nice summation of all of our experience, stuff like that. That's actually a nice photo. Those are the crabs, I think. We see Loki. And the nice end of chapter to finish. I think we'll see what we can do with regards to just trying to find a nearby haven. As we enter here, Chapter 3, The Open World. The Empire is a powerful foe, and Noctis has far to travel before he can hope to reclaim the crystal. He sets out across new lands in search of the power of his forebears. So yeah, pretty much we'll just find the nearest haven and stay there, or as it may be, the nearest parking spot for us to rest up in. Whichever one works is particularly useful. So obviously we saw Loki there, one of sort of like Niflheim's sort of high-ranking generals. He sort of gets that introduction there and then sort of disappears for a while. He's not one of the sort of major antagonists in the game. I think he is met again in another post-game area.
The prince eludes death. And what of the elusive ring?
Eluna Freya has absconded with it.
Find and kill her. The ring is the final piece.
We may do well to take her alive. The Six wield power beyond our imagination. The Oracle holds the key for the King. She could unlock many secrets. Nay, High Commander. Lord Ravis, the Imperial Army is now at your disposal.
A moot point. While the fugitives remain at large. My men and I will continue our search for the Prince and the Oracle.
So glorious. My crystal.
So a proper introduction to a large number of the, here we come. Antagonists of the game. We'll talk about that though in the next episode. Comparison to
lead. Bigger's better. More stuff to see and do.
First comes to Sky, a region known for its wetlands.
Really? Wetlands?
There's also a chocobo forest.
Now we're talking.
Further west lies the Klain region, wherein we'll find the town of Lestalum.
Oh, isn't that where Iris is headed?
Barring delays, she should have arrived by now. Maybe even had herself a look at the meteor.
The meteor of the Six?
The same. Its heat is harnessed to power, Lestalum.
Whoa, that sounds way cool.
I'm actually looking forward to this.
So, our first stop is here at Koenig Station, Ulster.
Best fill up the tank before we set out.
And here, as you can see, is another, we can immediately see that there is some quests for us to see.
The seat is yours, Noct, if you so desire it.
And now we can forever drive, we can now drive whenever we want, which is rather cool. We're actually going to get a phone call.
Hello?
Noct?
Iris?
It's really you. So good to hear your voice. Everything's fine over here. We managed to make it to Lestalum. Just settled into our new digs. So yeah, let me know when you're coming so we can meet up.
Yeah, will do.
You better.
So there we go, we have a new main quest.
Can't even call our own brother.
In all fairness, yours wasn't the obituary broadcast all over Lucis.
What about me? She say anything about me? Did you see that sign? Chocobos! Chocobos!
No time for that. Need to get to Lestalum.
It's still ages away. Come on, just a quick visit.
So we sort of have a choice. We can either go to the Chocobos or Lestalum. Sure. We'll save the chocobos because
yes! Gonna be awesome.
We definitely want to go to the chocobos because chocobos are important. But that is all in future episodes. For now, we're going to stay here at the caravan here at Koenig's Ulster.
You ready to rumble, Nut?
I hope you have enjoyed this episode of my walkthrough of Final Fantasy XV. We've completed Chapter 2, and now everything has opened up. Chapter 3 is really where this game starts to become big. And, there's going to be an awful lot in it for us. A lot of missions, a lot of new things. I guess I will see you on the next episode, where we will begin...
Hey.
So, I guess we will begin on the next episode. Hope to see you then.